Hey everyone, Jason here, entrepreneur and digital marketer, and in this Instagram video tutorial, we're gonna be going over the three keys to success when it comes to crafting a perfect Instagram content plan, as well as the five simple steps to implement your Instagram content plan. Make sure you check out the links in the description to other Instagram tutorial videos, like how to make awesome Instagram quote posts in Canva, as well as a complete guide to growing your Instagram account organically. And that'll be step two after we cover how to put together your Instagram plan in this video. So the first key to success when it comes to Instagram is making sure you're providing real content to your followers. And this is a huge mistake a lot of new Instagrammers make. And whether you're trying to grow your brand, you're selling something through Shopify dropshipping, or you're looking to become an influencer, whatever it is, you have to remember that content is king on Instagram. And so what this means practically is stop hawking your products or services on Instagram. Maybe one post out of 10 at most should talk about something where you're going to receive a monetary benefit. Most of the time, the other nine posts should be 100% content, value, not pitching or selling anything. The second key to success with Instagram is no fake followers. There are no more shortcuts. Since Facebook has bought Instagram, they've been doing a lot of work, and I mean a lot of work, to close every single possible loophole and every single black hat strategy there is for growing on Instagram. So you may have seen these old blog posts that talk about follow for follow. They talk about getting fake likes or fake followers, you know, to boost so you can find actual normal, real people to follow you. None of that works anymore. In fact, I recently did an experiment where I used one of these quote unquote fast growth services. You can check out the links in the description and also in the card. And that video completely debunks buying likes or followers to speed the growth of your account. It's all about content and hashtags at this point, which leads me into key to success number three, and that is build your swipe file. Yes, you want to be original with your content. Yes, you want to find your own style. But in the beginning, it's really just about figuring out what kind of content works to bring in the type of people you want following you. And the best way to do that is to find content from creators who are already connecting with and bringing in followers that you want. So go ahead and every day bookmark at least three or four posts that you like, so that when you get into creating your content plan, you already have a library of post ideas, and so you're not having to come up with something new every time you need to make a new post. And now that we have those three keys to success, it's time to dive into the five steps to creating your Instagram content plan, and that starts with who. Who are you and why should people care? And this is going to be all about your bio and specifically your bio link. So quick note on your bio link, remember that this is the only link that you can use to drive people off of Instagram. Everything else happens inside the Instagram ecosystem, so it's important that you choose a link that's strategic in terms of what you want people to do when they leave Instagram. So if you're doing affiliate links, you're gonna wanna use something like PrettyLinks to make sure that the URL isn't super long and ugly. If you're just driving people to your blog or social channels, you can use a link shortener like Bitly, but you definitely don't wanna use Bitly if you're doing an affiliate link. Now, when it comes to what happens above your bio link, that is where you communicate who you are and why people should care. You can also include hashtags here, so you can clearly tell Instagram the type of account that you are. But when you're just getting started, you want it to be broad enough where you're not restricting yourself on the type of content you can make, but you don't want it to be so broad where it's just like lifestyle Instagrammer or something silly like that where people just don't know what it means. And coming up with a really quick tagline is another key element to ensuring that you attract the right people. You may have seen this on other people's bios where they have a bunch of different titles. They say CEO of this, founder of that. We all know that's BS, right? So please don't do that. Be short, sweet, to the point, and don't pretend like you're something that you're not, because it's just gonna drive away real people. Now, step number two to creating your content plan is actually deciding what types of posts to make. So even though in your bio you can be somewhat broad, you definitely want to have a very centered focus when it comes to your content so that people don't feel like you're posting random things. Now, there are two elements to this. There's the type of post that you make and then the content of those posts. So for the content of those posts, you want congruency throughout. So let's just use the example of baking. Let's say we're putting together an Instagram account and it's gonna be all about baking. Well, baking is great, but baking could include birthday cakes, you know, cupcakes, and kale chips, right? Because kale chips you could actually bake in the oven. Well, one of those doesn't really seem to fit, even though it's technically still baking. Whereas if your feed just focused on baking and cake specifically, then birthday cake, you know, pound cake or chocolate cake or whatever would be show a much more congruent feed theme and content plan than just showing a bunch of things that you can bake in an oven. Another great example is cars. You know, you wouldn't have, you know, a post of really nice cars and then all of a sudden a old Toyota in the mix. Even though they're all cars, there's not a lot of congruency between having, you know, a bunch of nice cars and then all of a sudden an old retro one. So you definitely want to make sure that your the type of content you're making is not all over the place. Now, when it comes to the types of content you can make, there are a lot of different types, right? We have Instagram TV now. You can just focus on stories. You can have stock photos with quotes on top. You can be doing actual photo shoots, you know, so you want to come up with 3 to 4 types of posts that you would want to do. And then for your first round, just choose one. So when you're just getting started with your Instagram content plan, have just one type of post. If you go to my feed, you'll see that all of them are text quote posts. That's pretty much all I do. I started out doing real life posts, but then I didn't have time. And we'll get into that in number three, because number three is consistency, which is why you're only going to choose one type of post and one specific type of content, because being consistent with Instagram is key. So whether you're doing a post every day or you're doing some lives or you're going to be doing some stories, what's important is there's a touch point every single day on Instagram, even if it's not your main platform. You have to remember that most posts only have a couple hours lifespan. And so in an ecosystem like that, you really, really have to be on top of it and constantly contributing content to it. And choosing one type of post will allow you to be able to stay consistent, because you're gonna be batching your posts, which is actually step number 5, but I'm getting ahead of myself. So step number 4, now that you know what your content's going to be about, you have a general idea of the type of posts that you're gonna be making, it's time to make your content calendar. And you can check out the link in the description to the Aspire Notebook, where you can download a free version of my content calendar for YouTube, but we also use the exact same Google Sheet for Instagram as well. And so essentially what you want to do here is you're going to go over to Instagram, go into your audience insights, and if you haven't turned on business tools yet, go ahead and check out the link in the description. There's a video that shows you how to do that. And you're gonna look at, when are your followers most engaged? So even if you only have 100 people, that's 100 people who are engaged with you. So post at the same time that they're on and they want to see and engage with your content. And plan out when you're gonna post, what days you're gonna post, what type of post is it going to be, and whether you're gonna be doing a normal post or you're gonna do a couple stories or you're going to do a live. It takes a lot of pressure off when you know at the beginning of the week when you're going to do what you're going to do and when you're going to do it for your Instagram content plan, which leads me into number 5, which I already gave away: batching your content. So if you're making something like fun text quote posts like I do for mine, you're going to want to do those all in one fell swoop, so that as you're going throughout your day or during the week, if life happens, you know, you don't have the time necessarily every single day to make a new post. You already have your library done, and all you have to do is open up Instagram, post, engage for a little bit, and then get on with whatever else you're working on. So that does it for the 3 keys to success when it comes to creating your content plan for Instagram, as well as 5 simple steps for creating your content plan for Instagram. So I'm curious to hear from you what you would add or subtract from this list, and what your experience or strategies have been for being successful with your own Instagram content plan. Go ahead and comment below. I read and reply to every single one. So if you got some value out of this video, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more Instagram marketing tactics, just like the ones covered in this video, as well as in-depth marketing tutorials to help you generate income online. So go ahead, hit that like button, subscribe, comment below if you have any questions, and as always, keep building the business you love.